Hallo, wir sind noch immer auf dem Berlin-Festival. Hier sind wir mit der Band Tomahawk gerade beim Kochen im Backstage-Bereich, eigentlich dem Artist-Backstage, wo gekocht wird für die Künstler, aber hier wird noch selber gekocht. Wir sehen hier John Stanier, wie er gerade die Blutwürste serviert an seinen Bandkollegen. Und ja, im Folgenden werden wir mit ihnen noch ein paar Sachen zubereiten und dann auch ein bisschen über das Kochen sprechen. So when you are preparing for a tour, when you guys hang out in rehearsal, are you also sometimes cooking together? Because I know my friend John is quite into food too, so I thought...
Wayne cooked for me when I stayed at his house.
Oh, that's right. Wayne cooks really good Tex-Mex.
And you're really good in that?
I'm okay.
Oh,
I'm okay.
He's good.
I make basic American things like schnitzel and sauerbraten. And, you know, basically just American things like that.
Hallo, also wir sind immer noch hier beim Kochen mit Tomahawk. Wie ihr seht, sind die Gerichte mittlerweile ein bisschen zugerichtet. Wir essen hier die ganze Zeit Blutwurst, Doraten, alles geräuchert, geräucherten Aal. Den Jungs hat es auch ziemlich gut schon geschmeckt und jetzt sprechen wir einfach noch ein bisschen über das Tourleben und Essen. So you guys are on tour for a month or something like that. Like how would you, like, did the tour run good?
Yeah, it was 2.5 weeks. We've been doing a lot of short runs all year. But yeah, this was a good run. A few festivals, a few club shows. Had its ups and downs. We were in England, for God's sakes.
Guess which direction that was.
Okay, I see you like England a lot.
I don't mind. I love London, actually. I think it's a great town. Food in England, especially if you're playing a festival like Leeds or Reading, forget about it.
They don't take care of the bands?
Well, they have catering and stuff, but...
It's more like food is a chore as opposed to a pleasure experience. I mean, when I first went there, whatever, 25 years ago, I mean, there was no options. Now, if you want to spend the money and do the research, you can find really good shit. But just on a tour like this, where some nights we won't have a hotel and we're out in the middle of a field somewhere.
It's raining.
Years ago, England didn't even have coffee.
It was harsh, man. That instant fucking coffee.
Yeah.
Well, Americans are not that good with coffee either, right? Like when I came, like, in the early 90s to the States the first time, it was hard.
Changed a lot.
It was hard. Starbucks is from America, okay?
I know. But you saying Starbucks changed the game to the better?
In the big picture, yes, I think it did, actually.
Are you home cookers or are you restaurant people?
I cook at home a lot. Pretty simple stuff, healthy vegetables, rice, you know. But occasionally I crave a steak or something. I go out to Peter Luger's, or I go get
Luger's,
or I go to Taro Sushi. You know, I try not to hold back too much. But at home, you know, it's pretty simple.
And you?
Both. The first thing when I get home off a tour, though, I really want to stay home. Like, it's exotic to lock the door and just not leave. Because we eat in restaurants every night. Well, almost. And,
yeah.
So it's nice to cook. My wife's Italian, so she taught me a few things. But I was a horrible cook before I met her. Horrible, horrible.
And you?
I am a horrible cook, but my girlfriend is an amazing cook, so.
There you go.
And she likes to cook, so. I'll eat
but
that.
Does she teach you? Like,
no.
She
doesn't have the patience.
Some guy came up to us outside here and goes, you know, some guy working at the airport, if this was still an airport. Or say we go to the fucking Tegel tomorrow and some guy goes, I got this song.
Check out my demo.
No patience.
Yeah.
We go, fuck you. You don't know what you're doing. And that's
or if the baggage handler came up to you and was like, yeah, I just bought your new record, I really like it. But on the third song, if you would have played this, I play bass too, by the way. And what I would have done is this. And if you would have done that, it would have made the song better. Bye.
Like when I turned to that guy, Rozelle, this beatboxer, I'd never seen someone that got more not worse. And it's cool to get a demo, you know, but more people coming up to him, man, check this out.
Oh, man.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah. Unbelievable. Yeah. Airport, people in suits, people in hotels.
As if he would want to hear that.
Yeah, yeah, he's just...
Even if the guy was good, I mean...
So over it.
It's funny, because when I said, like, we cook here and then we go outside to sit here, your manager said, like it's not a good idea to sit in the artist area because the other artists get on your nerves. Is it like that artists don't let other artists eat?
Well, I don't want the Pet Shop Boys coming in here and trying to steal our fish.